Good morning, my dear students. I am going to start 13th class today. Last class I was discussing regarding the transient heat transfer. That is a one-dimensional unsteady state heat transfer. So transient conduction and use of temperature charts, one dimensional unsteady state heat conduction, that is a lumped system analysis. This is most important, you have to remember this lumped system analysis. Okay, and the following are the assumptions made for yesterday. I discussed how the different examples are also given, and directly I'm coming to the lumped system analysis. Consider a solid arbitrary shape, volume V, total surface area A, thermal conductivity K, density rho, specific heat at constant pressure is Cp, at a uniform temperature T0 is suddenly immersed in a liquid, well stirred liquid at time t is equal to 0, and which is kept at uniform temperature T0. Okay, the figure illustrates the considered heat transfer system and thermal network for single capacity system as shown in figure 4.2. So these are the properties of the solid arbitrary shape, volume, conductivity, density, surface area and specific heat and temperature at which it's going to be immersed in a well stirred fluid at a time t is equal to 0. So the figure is looking like this, and you are considering this as arbitrary surface, and it is having a property, volume, specific heat, density, initial temperature and temperature of the medium. Okay, this is the ambient temperature at T infinity and H. A is the surface area. This is called lumped system analysis for a transient heat flow. It means unsteady state one dimensional heat conduction. Okay, when it is this surface area A is immersed in a well stirred fluid, and what are the changes that going to be occurred? So this is also explained in electrical analogy by, so the thermal network for a single capacity system, you know that this is the resistance offered and this is the energy accumulated, and we are going to dip it in the water. That is energy getting dissipated here, and this is, don't give importance to this, it's only a representation that how the electrical analogy is taken. That is thermal network, how it works with a heat storage. So the heat transfer, when the heat transfer between a solid and liquid takes place by pure convection. So the, suppose this is the vessel. It is having water. I am just putting a arbitrary shape material which is very hard, and I'll immerse it in the water. Immerse in the well stirred fluid. It means it's a stirred fluid. And what happens when it is a hard body is immersed into a liquid? So it is very clear that heat is going to be get transferred to the fluid. Heat is going transferred to the fluid from the material which is hot, the heat start flowing, because the between the surface and the liquid is convection heat transfer. It means the heat is getting conducted from the center of the object to the liquid through convection, because water has got very high heat transfer coefficient, and heat transfer takes place through convection. It assumes that temperature distribution within the solid at any instant is sufficiently uniform. We assume that. It means this body which is immersed is having a sufficiently uniform temperature, and this transfer of heat from solid to the liquid or the well stirred fluid, and it is happen in a given time. It means it is a function of time. The heat transfer is a function of time. It means over a period of time this body is going to be get cooled. Okay, so consider a human, that is the function of time only, that the energy equation for the heat transfer in the solid may be stated by the definition which is given. Rate of heat flow into the solid of volume V through boundary surface A is equal to the rate of increase in the internal energy of the solid of the volume. It means the amount of heat, it may be cooled or it may be heated, both may occur. If the cold body is immersed in a hot fluid, then the heat is flowing like this, isn't it? When the hot body is immersed in a cold fluid, the heat transfer takes place like this. There are two ways possible. Either it may be energy accumulation or energy releasing. Change in internal energy occurs. That is what I can say. Change in internal energy means it may be heat addition, it may be heat removal. That is a change in the internal energy. So the rate of heat flow of solid of volume through the boundary surface, what will be the equation? This equation, that is HA and delta T, temperature T, from this to the liquid it's going. So what is the change in the internal energy because of it losing heat or gaining heat? What will be the internal energy change? Internal energy change is MCP delta T. MCP delta T is the internal energy change. So the simple equation which I written. So how do you write this into HA T infinity minus of T wall, which I am taking. You may assume that RTT at temperature time T. It means whatever may be the duration of time, you can take that wall temperature, how long it will be exposed. That is the duration of time that you are going to consider. It's equal to, so mass can be written as density into volume, because density is equal to mass by volume. Therefore, mass is equal to density into volume into Cp into change in temperature. Change in temperature is dT by dT, I can write. Change in temperature is always represented as change in temperature over a time dT. dT means small t also can be written. dT is equal to dT, I can write. dT. It means change in the timings with respect to the temperature changes with respect to time. Temperature change of temperature with respect to time is taken as dT by dT. This is what the equation I written here for energy balance. Okay. When the system is immersed in liquid, whether it is heating or cooling, let us take it later. Okay. So now, how do you simplify this equation? The simplification can be carried out. So I can write dT by dT. Okay. Plus HA by rho CPV, rho V CP is equal to multiplied by, I'll change that notation, temperature at a time and T infinity. Temperature at a given time and also the temperature of the system is equal to zero. So it is this, this equation is get modified to this version. So this put M is equal to HA by rho CPV. So what do you get? dT by d tau plus of M theta and TT minus T infinity is equal to theta, I can take. Substituting these two quantities, you will get this equation, that is equal to zero. So what is the next derivation that you are going to get? See, after substituting this, you have to integrate with respect to theta. Integrate with respect to theta. When you are putting this, this also you take it as theta only. So I can write this as d theta d theta at time t divided by d tau. Again, this is theta. Let me see what is that mistake I've done. D theta only I've taken. Here it is theta t. D theta t to theta. That is here wrongly typed here. D theta. You go to the next and the solution will be like this. Theta plus r. And the mistake, can you observe this here? Minus m d tau is equal to minus m integral of d tau. This is integration, this is at time t. Theta t I have taken here, this is at t. This is also a temperature at time t, you have to take, and this is also marked as t. So after integration, what you get? You get ln theta t is equal to minus m so look at the next minus m dot t plus c1 constant of integration. This is ln of theta t is equal to m dot t, because d tau is time t, means you can also take like that, plus c, constant of integration, c1 we call it as. Okay. So by considering the boundary condition, what are the boundary condition that you have to consider to find out the temperature distribution equation? So t is equal to, when time t is equal to t0, at time t equal to 0, where t is the initial body temperature of the solid, or solid may be cooled or heated. Okay, you substitute this boundary condition here, what do you get? Time t is equal to 0 means this quantity gets to 0, and c1 is equal to logarithmic of a temperature difference you get. Okay, that t is also 0, then what you can write here? Time t equal to 0, theta 0 I can write. So my general solution for this condition is, substitute back this into this equation, ln theta t. ln theta t is equal to m dot t plus of ln theta naught. So if you take it this side, what you get? Ln of theta t minus of ln of theta naught is equal to m into t. So you can write this as ln of theta t by theta naught is equal to m into t. This I am going to get it. If you take the solution for this equation, I can write this form, theta bar theta t by theta naught is equal to e to the power of minus mt. So this is the temperature distribution equation. Solution for this equation can be written. You take the you can write the solution for this. And what is theta t is, you can very well see that time t minus of t infinity divided by t zero initial temperature minus of t infinity is equal to e to power of minus mt. This equation is given in data and book, you can refer that. This equation is also given in the data and book, you can refer it. So this is what, and what are the parameter are included in this is the time T and the property of the material and the temperature. These are the composition of the equation is material property, time, and also the initial temperature and ambient temperature and also the base temperature. If the solid body of uniform thickness 2 delta or the solid cylinder or sphere diameter 2 delta is considered, then and what is the equation that's going to be modified and expressed in terms of Biot number and Fourier number and the geometrical ratio. The same equation, the simplification which I have given already. It is there in that, and it is only a rearrangement I have done in order to write it in the Biot number, Fourier number, and also ratio of geometry. It means non-dimensional for geometry in geometrical value. So if you write that, and how do you substitute these values into the temperature distribution equation? So here another equation I get, Tt minus of T infinity divided by T minus of T infinity, T0, base temperature, or the initial temperature, is equal to E to the power of minus, in the place of M, I can write Biot number, Fourier number, and also geometrical A delta by V. G naught you can go over it, right? This is the ratio of geometry. So the instead of this, I can write capital G. This is also a non-dimensional number, geometrical ratio. So where the definition of Biot number, Fourier number, and non-dimensional geometry are also given in the data handbook. I'll read out the page number and write the page number also. 1 minute. Page number 64. This is page number 64. Start from that. It is a transient conduction. Start from this point. And the definition also given. The Biot number definition is given. Fourier number definition is given. And also the geometrical, the non-dimensional geometry is also given. So to understand all this definition, you have to go to page number 9 dimensional numbers are given in page number 112 and also page number 112. These are important. You not have to remember any definition because all the definitions are given in the page number 112. That is, Biot number is internal conduction resistance divided by surface convection resistance. It means heat transfer coefficient of solid surface to the internal conductance of solid across the length L. Can also take it as HR by K or H delta by K. That is also given, internal conductance resistance divided by the surface convection resistance. In this book it is given. I have given a different way, the heat transfer coefficient of solid surface to the internal conductance of solid. If you change the, if you reverse this also, it won't affect H delta return divided by K return. If I write same Biot number into K by H delta, because it is a dimensionless number. This is watt per meter Kelvin. Here it is watt per meter square Kelvin and meter is there. Therefore, both two quantity get cancelled. You will get the non-dimensional number. So this is, and also the Fourier number definition is given. This is the third definition in this book and page number 112. The characteristic of body dimension, the ratio, this is the Fourier number is the ratio of characteristic body dimension divided by temperature wave penetration depth in time t. So rate of heat conduction across length L cube divided by rate of heat storage in length. Both are same, but it should be expressed in a different fashion. Even if you reverse this Fourier's number, the ratio, instead of writing k by rho cp, if you write rho cp by k, unit won't change. T by delta square is there. You can write delta square by t, it won't change. It means all the denominator can be written to numerator, numerator denominator, but this value will not change. It is a non-dimensional number. Non-geometry, non-dimensional geometry is g, that is a delta divided by volume, area into delta divided by volume. Henceforth, this definition is useful for analyzing the transient heat conduction. Theoretically, the body will take, so if any body is immersed in a stirred liquid, what happens to the body, how long it will keep dissipating heat to the surrounding, or how long it will take to reach, attain the steady state temperature. So that is called unsteady, which means there is a time taken to attain a steady condition, but particularly it comes very near to the steady state condition, but it cannot be, you have to wait very long period. If the body is getting heated up and then submerged in a cold fluid, and you wait for more than 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours, then only it will come to a steady state. Still it become almost the body temperature T infinity equal to the surrounding temperature T infinity. There are two conditions which I have given illustrated as shown in figure, and the condition is that time T versus the temperature distribution across the body, and whether it is M is increasing or decreasing. If it is a cooling body with zero internal resistance, then the graph 1, this is the graph 1, increasing M. M increases means it keep on decreasing. This graph e to the power of mx is keep on decreasing. Here it is increasing M in this direction. This is for heating. This is for cooling. Okay. Heating means temperature gradient is keep on increasing. Here it is keep on decreasing. Cooling means decreasing. Heating means increasing. This is what the representation when the body is submerged in a well-stirred fluid. Say, what is mixed boundary condition that you are going to see? As in your syllabus, it is very well mentioned that the Fourier, this one, a transient heat conduction with a different boundary condition is mentioned. Different geometry, different boundary condition. I attempted only two things. One is the temperature boundary condition and also mixed boundary condition. Mixed boundary condition means heat convection are taken. Okay. Consider a situation where the part of the body surface of the region is subjected to convection and remainder is subjected to prescribed heat flux as illustrated below. It means there are two boundary conditions which I have taken. One is prescribed heat flux and also convection boundary condition I have taken. So to summarize that, it is a T infinity actually, watt per meter square, it is not edited properly. So what are the geometries which I have taken? I am going to assume that an area, equal area A transfer on both sides of the plate, application of energy balance for a particular geometry which I have taken. So here the heat flux is applied and it is exposed to a convection heat transfer. Okay, I have taken the mixed boundary condition. Mixed boundary condition is that constant heat flux is applied across the plate at x is equal to 0 and the convection boundary is exposed at x is equal to L, length of the slab is L, and the slab is maintained at constant temperature TW. So the transient heat flow in a slab with mixed boundary condition, this is the geometry. One side is heat flux, another is convection. Okay, then let us see how the equation is going to be written. First is AQ, that is the amount of heat conducted and amount of heat change in the internal energy. Amount of heat is convected out for the convection and change in the internal energy. That is the equation. It means how much heat is conducted from the left into the system and causes a change, and how much is going out of the system, that is can be written. So by using a boundary condition, and this is the equation I am going to get, dt by d tau and for time greater than 0. By using initial boundary condition, when time t equal to 0, that t naught, substituting in the above equation, theta naught is equal to t infinity plus dt, substituting in this equation, again you have to integrate by substituting m and q, q is equal to capital Q by rho cp L. Substituting that, you will get a system like this. It means logarithmic some partial solution is missing here. We'll go to the next. This is the boundary condition. This is the temperature distribution equation with a constant C you'll get. And this is the solution that I am going to get. After that, what you have to, when time is equal to t is equal to 0, you have to put, you'll get tt is equal to theta t is equal to c e to the power of mt plus q by m. Substituting in the above equation, c is equal to t is equal to 0, substitute, what do you get? C is equal to theta naught minus qm. This means this will come this side. Substituting this in the above equation, again you'll get one more. And finally, you'll get the temperature distribution equation in this fashion. So the theta t dot by theta naught is equal to, because theta naught you have to take common factor here. Okay. And this is the equation 4.6 is the temperature distribution equation. And this is only a pure differential equation. How I derived that equation by taking, and I given a hint for this. You can also go through that. You can note down this, and then how I finally arrived at this solution. It requires a certain simplification by putting a some constant y is equal to like that, and then you have to integrate, finally substitute back, you will get that equation. Okay, this colored images which I am showing now, they are the simplified version, because you cannot able to get the solution directly unless you go through this, how to simplify this equation I given here by making some assumption. Okay, put y is equal to theta minus theta t, again you will take differentiating the equation here and substituting this in the above equation, you will get that. Okay, that's what you have given. You have to go through this and then finally arrive at this equation. This is the temperature distribution equation. What are the content of the temperature distribution equation you get? Here is theta t is t minus of t infinity. Theta naught is t naught minus t infinity. Okay, that already taken there. So here, what are the parameters are involved in calculating is time t and material property and the heat flux and the convection boundary condition. So the left hand side of this equation is temperature, and here also right hand side you will get the temperature difference, because this equation is homogeneous equation. Okay, so this equation is also given in the data handbook. You can also refer the mixed boundary condition, the data handbook, it is given. You can directly take this and then start solving the problem. Page number 64. And I'll repeat once again, this is the energy balance equation which I have written. This is the geometry is considered, and this is what the energy balance, energy, heat flux to the left side and the heat conducted on the right side. It is going out is minus, I have taken it as a plus here, and the change in internal energy with respect to the time, that is rho A L, rho V. Instead of V, I have written mass as rho V A L and Cp into delta T. Delta T is dT by dτ. Okay, this is what I have taken and accordingly simplified, and finally got this equation. This equation, equation 4.6. This is the final equation that I am going to get. Okay. And this is what the simplification I have done to the left side, but I also copied it here for the information how I have taken this. Let us go to the solving few problems on lumped system analysis. Now only I am using theta by theta naught is equal to e to the power of mx. This equation I am going to solve. Theta by theta t by theta naught is equal to e to the power of minus mt. This on this equation for the lumped system analysis I am going to solve problem. By considering one of the problem, an aluminum plate conductivity 160 watt per meter degree Celsius and specific heat at constant pressure is 1880 joule per kg Kelvin or degree Celsius. Density of the material, that is aluminum, is 2790 kg per meter cube, of thickness 3 centimeter, thickness L is equal to 3 centimeter, and at a uniform temperature of T0, base temperature is 225 degree Celsius. It is suddenly immersed at time t is equal to 0 in a well-stirred fluid maintaining at a constant temperature of 25. It means fluid temperature is 25, the body temperature is 225. The heat transfer coefficient between the plate and fluid is 320 watt per meter square degree Celsius. Determine the time required for center of the plate to reach 50 degrees Celsius. So this is what you have to time duration you have to calculate. By modeling you can see that this is the plate thickness. It is immersed in a 25 degree Celsius. What will be the temperature 50 degree to reach? What will be the time T is equal to question mark. Time is equal to question mark. That's what he is asked. So what is the temperature of the body it is maintained? It is maintained at 225. At x is equal to 0, T is equal to 225. That is base temperature, T naught. T infinity is given. And the T is the temperature. T naught is the, this is TT. Time T equal to 0. Time T equal to 0 at this point. Then soon after the immersion, time will start. At what time T naught you are going to get? That time will be. In this problem, it can be solved by lumped system analysis, sufficient accuracy, with a sufficient accuracy of Biot number. See, now what is the yardstick or the quantity that you have to identify first. If it is Biot number is less than 1.01, Biot number is less than 0.1. Then only the lumped system analysis is applicable. Otherwise, you have to go for a transient heat chart for calculating the time duration. Therefore, we need to check the magnitude of Biot number and characteristic length LS is to be determined as follows. And then you apply that and then calculate the time duration. Okay. So now I am going to calculate the Biot number first. So the LS is volume by area. Characteristic length is volume divided by area. So this is a plot. This is L into A. This is volume. Area is A only. A get cancelled. You get LS. What is that LS? The half the length you have to take, because half the length is L by 2, LS by 2. So your half the length is LS by 2. What do you get? Length is how much is given? 3. 3 by 2 is 1.5. 1.5 is half the length, centimeter. That you have to convert that to 2 meter later by substitution. So the Biot number can be calculated because that is converted again heat transfer coefficient divided by LS divided by K is. So it is 3 into 10 raised to minus 2. Biot number 3 into 10 raised to minus 2. It is far, far less than 0.1. So therefore, lumped system, hence the lumped system analysis is applicable by using the temperature distribution equation T time T infinity divided by T0 minus T infinity is equal to E power of minus M into T. You have to find out the temperature, sorry, time T from this. So what is the M value? M is equal to, as derived by that, HA by rho CPV. HA by rho CPV. So this area and volume is get cancelled. You can write this equation as M H divided by rho CP LS, because characteristic length is known to you. You can convert that into LS. That is, area is areas get cancelled, you get LS here, and then that's what I written here. So after substituting the values into this equation, and you will get time duration. Simplify this. Time will get 3 239 seconds. That is almost equal to 4 minutes. It means what? When the body of length 3 cm is immersed into a liquid at 25 degree and its surface temperature is 225, and how much time it will take to attain the center temperature to 50 degree. See, time TT, time T, this TT is known to you. This temperature you want to calculate. It means what time it's going to reach 50 degree. 50 minus 25, this is 225 minus 25, and e to the power of whatever the m value is there, substitute and calculate time t, and appropriately you have to use the calculator, the exponential function you have to use, and then you have to calculate this, you will get the 4 minute time. This is what the problem. Problems are pretty simple in this transient heat conduction, but only thing is you know how to refer the data handbook and how to take the equation. Calculating the Biot number value, if it is far less than 0.1, then only lumped system analysis is applicable. Only one equation is there. This is the equation that I am going to consider. For calculating time in the transient heat conduction. Okay. Next, coming to the next problem. The temperature of the gas stream is measured with a thermocouple. The junction may be approximated as a sphere of diameter d naught 1 millimeter, conductivity 25 watt per meter degree Celsius. Specificated constant pressure is 400 joule per kg Kelvin or degree Celsius. Density of that sphere is 8400 kg per meter cube. And the heat transfer coefficient between junction and the gas stream is 50 watt per meter square. Degree Celsius is missing here, you can write down. How long it will take the thermocouple to record 99% of the applied temperature difference? It means to reach, to attain 99%, how long it will be applied. So, okay. Solution, again, you will have to calculate the characteristic length. That is, sphere volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube and area is pi r square, 4 pi r square, you will get 1 by 6. And Biot number, if you substitute, you will get, it is 3.7, this is actually into, not plus, okay. This is supposed to be into 10 raised to minus 3. Okay, and it is far less than 0.1, hence the lumped system analysis is applicable. Using the temperature distribution, temperature at time t minus of ambient temperature and the initial temperature minus the ambient temperature is equal to e to the power of mt. When the temperature reaches 99% of the applied temperature is 1%. 1% means 1 by 100. Only 1% left out, that is 1 by 100. 1 by 100 temperature you have to take here and substitute in the value, you will get mt is equal to 4.6. Substitute in the m value you get, time you will get 4.6 seconds. This is very simple, within no time you can calculate. Okay, similarly, the third problem that I am going to take up. You know the household electric iron box, you are familiar with that. Electric box, everybody using iron box for ironing your cloth, that is called squeezing your cloth, and by removing the moisture in the cloth so that the fiber becomes tight. For that you have to apply the heat, fiber becomes tight and wrinkles may be eliminated from the fabric by heating it. And the household electric iron is the base which is having conductivity 70 watt per meter degree Celsius, and CP value is given, density value is given, which weighs around 1 kg. It means weight of the iron box is given. Okay, the base has the an ironing surface of area 0.025 meter square and is heated from outside surface with the 250 watt heating element. Initially the iron box base is at uniform temperature 20 degree Celsius, the initial temperature that is given. Suddenly, the heating start, the iron dissipates heat by convection from the ironing surface into the ambient at T infinity with a heat transfer coefficient of 50 watts per meter square degree Celsius. That degree Celsius is missing there again. You have to note down that, and here it is given in the data. I don't know how it is missed out here. And watt per meter square degree Celsius, it is given here. Okay, calculate the temperature of the iron box at after time t is equal to 5 minutes after the start of heating. What would be the equilibrium temperature for the iron to be control did not switch off the current. You know, the some bimetallic switch is there in the iron box. Automatically, after reaching certain temperature, it's going to switch off. It means power supply is cut off. So this is a mixed boundary condition. So this geometry, the special iron box, is taken as a mixed boundary condition because the heat flux is supplied to the system, and also known heat transfer coefficient also given. Okay. Iron box is taken like this. The example I am going to take, this is the iron box heating surface, and the iron box looks like this. And with the handle, we have the electric wire here. Okay, this is the handle, and it is having some knob here for controlling. And this is the wall I am going to consider. So here is the heating coil connected to wire to a switch. Now this surface is taken for calculation. How much is the time taken to reach the temperature? It means if the electric coil electricity is not switched off, what will be the temperature after 5 minutes? That's going to be taken. So you know that the boundary condition, the temperature distribution equation that I derived, that I have taken here. And T is 20 minus 20 is 0, and the Q value, that is 250 watt coil divided by the surface area, will guess the watt per meter square, that is 10,000 watt per meter square area, that is the flux quantity, and convection heat transfer coefficient is given. Substituting in the M value, you will get this M is equal to 0.27 into 10 raised to minus 2, you will get. So the temperature at the end of T 5 minutes is determined as MT. You take MT value, substitute in MT value in this. Finally, how much you get? So this is the temperature, that is 133 degree it's going to reach after 5 minutes. That is the equilibrium temperature becomes after 5 minutes is this, because 5 minutes is taken into consideration here. 5 into 16 seconds, right? M value, 5 into 60 seconds, this is the MT value. This is per meter, the M value is per second. Here, M value is second, per second it should be. Second, second get cancelled, you will get that value. What is the unit of M is per second? M value is per second. So, this is the one practical example I taken, and how how much time it will take after 5 minutes, what will be the temperature. You can also have your own iron box at home, note down the temperature and how long you have to wait to reach that temperature. It means to remove the moisture in the cloth or in the fabric, see, you need 110 degree maximum. You should not heat beyond certain temperature so that fabric going to be get burnt. It means 100 degree means all the water which is there, moisture is there in the fabric, it's going to be get evaporated at 100 degree. If you have only excess of 10 to 20 degrees, more than enough for you to iron it. Sometimes you may go beyond a certain control, because control is not, did not switch off, the iron box going to be get heated up to very high up, high value. Finally, you place the iron box on the fabric, fabric going to get hot. Okay, you have your own example at iron box in everywhere, every house you have got iron box. Now you can calculate similar way, and you can bring out your own numerical example. Okay, see, coming to the next topic of interest for discussion as for the syllabus, the use of transient temperature charts, that is Heisler chart or Grover chart, you call it as. In your syllabus it is mentioned that using Heisler chart and Grover chart to find out the temperature distribution and also the time duration, how long you can heat, how long you can cool. And this is one different, if the Biot number is greater than 1, the problem applied is the all these Heisler charts or Grover chart is used analyzing by referring a Biot number. If it is greater than 1, then only you can use this charts. If it is less than 1, directly you can use it, directly you can use the lumped system analysis, that is theta t by theta naught is equal to e to the power of minus mt. If it is greater than 1, Biot number is greater than 1. What is Biot number? H delta by k. H delta by k. H delta is means thickness of the body into heat transfer coefficient divided by conductivity is called the Biot number. So if you using if you are using this, then the analysis of conduction problem involves the determination of temperature distribution within the solid as a function of time and position. It means what position the temperature is there, and it is a very complicated situation to analyze. And if this complex problem can be analyzed in one dimensional through Heisler charts, it means Heisler is one who has created this transient temperature charts. By referring directly, you can solve the problem given. Okay, so that is determination of temperature distribution within the solid as a function of time and position. See, the temperature distribution of body is determined as a function of time and position. See, for a slab, transient conduction in slab, consider a slab of thickness 2L that is confined to a region minus L into X and plus L. How do you take this slab? Slab can be taken like this. Here is minus L, negative point coordinate, and this is the plus coordinate, and here it is 0. From the center you are counting. What is the total length is? Total length is 2L. Total length is 2L. Okay. Consider a slab 2L and that is confined to a region minus L less than or equal to X less than or equal to L. Initially, the slab is at uniform temperature Ti, and suddenly at time t is equal to 0, both boundary surface of the slab subjected to convection heat transfer coefficient, convection with a heat transfer coefficient H into the ambient air temperature T infinity, and are maintained for a long period time greater than 0, shown in figure A and B, the geometry, coordinate and boundary conditions of problem explained with a time dependent heat conduction problems. So that is what these are the two conditions which are taken, geometry, coordinate and boundary conditions of transient heat conduction in a slab. So this is at 0, minus L plus L, and this is the conductivity, convection heat transfer coming left side and conducted into the body, and it is at initial temperature, and the whatever the heat is getting conducted it and convected out at the this surface. Or else you can consider x is equal to L. X is equal to L means length L. Initially this, and dt by dx is equal to 0 at this, and it's this is the energy balance. There are two boundary conditions at the geometry coordinate and boundary conditions of transient heat conduction in the slab is taken like this. Time is up now. I am going to close it and continue in this next class. Slide number 29. Okay. Thank you very much.